Assalamualaikum. Today my group will present SEL1 MPH 3102 question 4A and 5B. But before that, my group contain 5 member, which is me, Fatin Nadira Muzaba, and Siti Maisara binti Karudin, Nurul Syedwani binti Muhammad Jasmani, Syaira binti Alia, and Nabila Aida.
Alright, now we proceed for the section A, question 4A. So the question gives 2 equations, that is 2dx dt plus dy dt equal to 5dt. And the second equation is negative 3dx dt plus dy dt equal to r, where r equal to 1, t equal to 0, x equal to 0, and y equal to 0. So the solution for this equation is, first we need to let LXT equal to US and LYT equal to VS. From the equation, we substitute the value of R and T, where R is 1 and T is 0. So the equation will become 5T0 become 5 and R equal to 1. After that, we need to add the Laplace and it will become 2LX prime T plus LY prime T equal to L5, and negative 3LX prime T plus LY prime T equal to L1. So now, as we know, LX prime T is equal to SLXT minus X0. So we substitute the equation to this equation and we will get 2SLXT minus negative X plus SLYT minus Y0 equal to L5. Same goes to the second equation. Next, from the initial condition, that means we substitute the value of LXT equal to US. So LXT we substitute to US and X0 we substitute to 0. So we get new 2 equations. Okay, from the 2 equations, we need to find the US and VS. So we need to do the Cramer's rule, where the Cramer's rule will give 5 over S, 1 over S like this, and we will get US equal to 4 over 5S, where VS we will get 17 over 5S squared. Then, if we want to get XT and YT, so we need to do the Laplace inverse of 4 over 5S. So we walk toward the constant and we need to find Laplace inverse of 1 over S from our table, then we will get 1. So XT is equal to 4 over 5. For the YT, same, we need to take out the constant 17 over 5 and find the Laplace inverse of 1 over S squared, where L inverse 1 over S squared equal to T, and YT is equal to 17 over 5.
Section B, eigen. Solve x prime equal to 3, negative 15, 5, 1, x, when x, t equal to 0, equal to 6, negative 10. So, based on the formula, a minus m identity equal to 0. So, we substitute a, which is x prime, into the formula. 3 negative 13, 5, 1 minus m, and the identity is 1001 equal to 0. And then we get 3 minus m negative 13, 5, 1 minus m equal to 0. So we use determinant to find the m. So 3 negative m multiply with 1 minus m minus multiplication of multiply of negative 13, 5 equal to 0. we get m squared negative 4m plus 6, 8 equal to 0. So we get the eigen is m equal to 2 plus minus 8i. So now we have to find the eigenvector for the equation a negative. So we use the formula a minus m identity minus plus multiply with c equal to 0. So we choose eigen value m equal to 2 plus 8i. So we substitute into the formula 3 minus m negative 13, 5, 1 minus m, c1, c2 equal to 0. So we get 1 minus 8i, c1 minus 13, c2 equal to 0. So we get c2 equal to 1 minus 8i, c1 divide by 13. Then we find the C, which is C1 and C2. So C1 is C1, C2 we substitute that we get before, 1 minus 8i multiplied over 13 C1. So we get 13 C1, 1 minus 8i C1. So we get, we multiply with we get 13 my 1 minus 8i. So we divide into two part, which is real and imaginary part. The next one is we use the formula xt et b1 in real part 13 1 cos 8t. 8 is, we have to find the alpha and beta, m equal to alpha plus minus I beta. We know that m equal to 1 plus minus ni. So we know that alpha equal to 1, beta equal to 8. So we substitute into the formula xt equal to et b1 imaginary and real part plus beta t minus imaginary part 0 negative 8 sin 8t plus b2 0 negative 8 cos 8t plus 13 1 sin 8t. So based on the question, we have to find x when t equal to 0, x equal to 6 negative 10. So we substitute the into the equation that we get x at t equal to 0 and x equal to 6 negative 10. So after that, after we substitute, we get b1 13 1 plus b2 0 negative 8 equal to 6 negative 10. So we use simultaneous equation 13 b1 plus 0 equal to 6, b1 equal to 6 over 13. So we substitute b1 into the second equation, b1 minus 8b2 equal to negative 10, negative 8b2 equal to negative 10, negative b1. So b1 we know that 6 negative 13. So b2 equal to 10 plus 6 over 13 equal over 8 equal to 17 over 13. After that, we, since we know the b1 and the b2, so we substitute back into the xt. Xt equal to et 6 over 13, the real part 13 1 cos alpha t minus 8t minus 0 negative 8 sin 8t plus b2 17 over 13 0 negative 8 cos 8t plus 13 1 sin 18. That's all, thank you.